Hi, my name is Sam El-Husseini and I'm a software engineer here at Google. I work on the kids coding team and today I'll be giving you an overview of Blockly's new developer tools. The Blockly Dev Tools package is an NPM package that contains a set of developer tools that are useful when developing and debugging Blockly. These dev tools are used by the Blockly team in the development of both Blockly Core and Blockly's new first-party plugins. Be sure to check out one of my other talks on Blockly plugins for more details on that. Today, the DevTools package consists of a playground, a number of toolboxes, helper methods for testing fields and stress tests, as well as test helper methods. The playground is an essential part of Blockly's development and testing. The new playground includes a graphical interface for changing Blockly options on the fly. It supports auto import, export, and generation of code using built-in generators. The playground includes a set of actions that can be taken on the workspace, such as formatting and clearing blocks. And it also includes a number of stress tests, a debug renderer, and a console logger. Here we see the playground. We can use the options on the side to change the workspace to RTL, switch the renderer to the Zelos renderer, change the theme, select a different toolbox, and the position of the toolbox. We can enable and disable the trash can, the scroll bars, and the zoom controls. We can change the starting zoom scale and make adjustments to the grid, such as its spacing, length, and color. You can always click the reset button to reset all the options to the default options. The playground also features automatic generation on the fly. As we move blocks around, the XML is generated. We can click on any of the other generator tabs to instead generate code from the blocks on the workspace. The auto checkbox is used to enable and disable this feature. The playground state is saved between page reloads, and when the auto checkbox is checked, the XML is used to import blocks into the workspace. The playground also features a set of actions that can be taken on the workspace, such as showing and hiding the workspace, formatting and clearing blocks, undoing and redoing, and a zoom actions such as zoom center. It also has a number of stress tests, such as populate random, which randomly adds blocks to the workspace, and spaghetti, which adds a nested set of if statements to the workspace. Let's take a look at how to create a playground. We can do so by importing the create playground method from @blockly/devtools. We then call the create playground method with a container div that we want to use to create the playground, and a create workspace method. The create workspace method is called every time the workspace is changed through the playground options. This method is called with a DOM element for Blockly to be injected into, and the set of options to pass the Blockly inject. If you have custom workspace initialization logic, this is an opportunity to add that, such as configuring the workspace context menu. The method expects a returned workspace. Default options can be passed to the playground and are set every time the reset button is clicked. The playground also saves the current state of the XML, as well as selection options between reload. The DevTools includes a number of toolboxes. Toolbox categories is Blockly's default built-in category toolbox. Toolbox Simple represents a simple no-flyout toolbox. Toolbox Test Blocks represents a number of Blockly's test blocks. These are actually re-exported by the DevTools package, but actually live in @blockly/block-test. The DevTools also includes a number of helper methods. Generate field test blocks is used to automatically define a number of field test blocks and generates a toolbox to access these blocks. Each property in the args object correlates to a property in the JSON definition of the field. In this case, it's value, but fields may use various properties in the JSON definition. The populate random function adds random blocks to a workspace. Blocks are selected from the full set of defined blocks. Pass in a workspace and how many blocks should be created. The spaghetti function is a renderer stress test that populates the workspace with nested if statements. Pass in a workspace and how deep the nesting should be. The DevTools also includes a number of test helpers. This will be covered in further detail in Monica's Block Test Helpers talk. Thank you for your attention, and I hope you enjoy Blockly's virtual summit.